Good morning, church family. It is Monday, April the 27th, and I'm praying for you today. I care for you and love you, miss you. I hope you are doing well today. Before we get into this devotion this morning, I just want to let you know that some days are harder than others for all of us, and today is one of those days for me, so I just want to pray that the verse that I'm about to read really resonates with you, and may the Holy Spirit just minister to you today. It actually comes out of the book of Philippians chapter 4. It's one of the, I think, one of the most recognizable verses. And it's a variation of do not be afraid. It says do not be anxious. And just want to let you know that Paul is writing this book in Philippians. He's in prison while he's writing it, so he is in prison and writing it in a place that can be and that can be in despair, can be a very bad, you know, place, can be treated bad or whatever. But he is writing it to encourage the church in Philippi, and so I'm going to read this, and hopefully it'll encourage you today, wherever you are, whatever church you attend. Just know that it is an encouragement. And my prayer is that we can do this today. It comes out of chapter 4, verse 6, and it basically says this. It says, do not be anxious about anything. That's our little phrase. Do not be afraid, do not fear not. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. And what I'm looking at today from this is the fact that God does give us His peace, but it kind of, this is an overall arching theme of every devotion I've done, is that in God there is hope, and in Jesus there is hope. And whenever you're in your own personal prisons, as Paul's in his, a literal prison, whenever you're in your own personal circumstances where you feel like you can't get out, or the hurt or the fear is overwhelming you, know that there is hope in Christ, that there is hope. And it says, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And my prayer is that today, you just send your request to God. You give it to God, whatever is on your heart, and then the peace of God, which transcends all understanding. I can't understand it, no matter what circumstances you're going through, no matter how hurt you may be today. May God give you that peace, His peace, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. And so I'm praying for you. I love you. And let's pray. Father God, I want to thank you for your Son Jesus and the grace and mercy that comes through Him. God, my prayer is that there are many people out here hurting today, but the fact is you are a God of hope. And that's what I'm leaning on today. God, in you there is hope. And my prayer is that as a people of God, as a family of God, Lord, that we can sit and just present our requests to you. And that somehow, some way, I don't get this, but the Holy Spirit will just give us the peace of God. That is my prayer. For those of us that are hurting today, may it be our prayer. And may it be our request, God. May it be my request for those that are hurt, that you give them their peace, Lord. Lord, we love you, and in you there's always hope. And I thank you for your Son, Jesus, and the life that He gives. In Christ's name, amen. Church family, I love you. I'm praying for you. I miss you. Remember to get into God's Word. It's the only truth out there that can build you up. It is truth, and in Christ, there is hope because He is the God of hope. God bless you guys. Have a great day.